Hey, how are you doing? My name is Evgeny and welcome back to my channel. Today I will try to touch upon the most popular topic among new developers. What programming language should I learn first? Well, let me give you the most cliche answer first, and then I will try to give you one language that I think will be the best for you. So, I think you should learn whatever language gets you excited. Pick any language and just try it. If you don't like it, try something else. Humans are all different and there is usually no single answer. Now that I have said that, I will go over the most popular languages and compare them. At the end, I will give you what I think is the best language for beginners and more experienced alike. Let's begin. I will start with the most popular language among new developers, which is Python. Python is a high level, easy to learn with less syntax technicalities programming language. I will go over the three qualities that I will use to compare each language. First, simplicity. Second, what is the language most used for? And the last one, how is it useful for beginners? Also, I will include the Hello World code snippet for each. So, Python simplicity. The foremost reason for Python being so popular is its simplicity. It uses a natural language at its base, so I can easily say that Python is the simplest language among all that I will review today. What Python is most used for? Well, it's a general purpose language, so you can use it for pretty much everything, but it's mostly used for AI, machine learning, data analytics, data visualization, and web development. How is Python useful for beginners? Well, like I said, it is very simple and easy to learn. Programming in Python is as simple as typing an English sentence on your system. Also, Python has been around for quite a while and it has a big community. You can always find an answer to any of your questions about it. Here's the Hello World code snippet for Python. You can pause the video to look close. Next is JavaScript. This is actually the language I started my IT career with, so I'm a bit biased. JavaScript, often abbreviated as JS, also don't confuse with Java. JavaScript is a programming language that is one of the core technology of the internet, alongside HTML and CSS. As of 2022, 98% of all websites use JavaScript. Simplicity. High level, easy programming language. In my opinion, it is a bit harder than Python because it has more syntax technicalities, but still easy to start with and easy to learn, most used for web and server-side development, mobile and GUI applications. JavaScript used to be only for web, but with new technologies, it became possible to use JavaScript pretty much everywhere. How is it useful for beginners? JavaScript has a huge community, which is always great because it would have a lot of tools already built around the ecosystem and probably has a lot of answer on Stack Overflow, which is also helpful. It is very easy to start with, and I think web development is one of the easiest way to get into an IT career. Here's the Hello World code snippet for JavaScript. Next up is C and C++. These languages are pretty old and still taught in universities. I personally wouldn't recommend them to beginners, but I understand why they would be useful. Simplicity. They are low level languages, very hard to learn and use. They are among the hardest languages out there. Most used for, well, anything where performance is number one priority, so game development, operating system, complicated lower level programs like trading application. How is it useful for beginners? By learning these languages, you will understand how all other languages work under the hood. You will learn how memory works, you will be aware of different types and how to use them. So these are pretty complicated languages, but they teach a lot. One of the perks of learning these languages is that after learning them, every language is easy. Here's the Hello World snippet for C++. Let's move to the next language, which is Go. Go, also called Golang, is an open source programming language for general purpose. Go was developed by Google engineers to create dependable and efficient software. Most similarly modeled after C, Go is statically typed and explicit. Golang has been the most desired language to learn for 3 years in a row among developers. Not only that, Go is the top 10 of the most loved languages to use and is the third most popular language on GitHub in terms of stars. Simplicity. I found it to be pretty simple to start with. It has excellent tutorials, though it is harder than JS or Python. What can be accomplished with a few lines of Python may take several lines in Golang. Most used for distributed network services, cloud native development, low level cloud computing, building fast backend services. So mostly it is used by DevOps and backend engineers. How is it useful for beginners? Well, I think it is simple, though many people will disagree with me. I believe it doesn't have too much of a learning curve like a C or C++, but it is very performant, so that's why I'm comparing it with those languages. If you are going to be a DevOps developer, then this is definitely the language for you. Here's the Hello World code snippet for Go. Next is everyone's favorite programming language, Rust. Rust is also an open source general purpose programming language for fast, low resources, cross-platform solutions. Software you know and love like Firefox, Dropbox and Cloudflare uses Rust. Also, Rust is the most loved language based on Stack Overflow developer survey, and it had this status for over 6 years now. Simplicity. Rust would be pretty complicated for beginners. In terms of difficulty of learning, I would compare it with probably C++, though maybe a bit less irritating. Most used for Rust is a low-level programming language with direct access to hardware and memory, which makes it a great solution for embedded and bare metal development. You can use Rust to write operating systems or microcontroller applications. Well, and because it is a general purpose language, you can use it for everything else. How is it useful for beginners? I would say Rust is pretty new, has a significant lack of resources, and so it's much harder as a first language. But working closer to hardware always teaches you more, so if you want some challenge, then Rust might be for you. I also found that their official tutorials and books are very nice resources to start. Here's the Hello World code snippet for Rust. So this is my list of languages that might be good for new developers. You can go wrong by choosing any of those languages. It's just a matter of your needs. But like I promised, if you don't know what to choose and just want a simple answer, then let's discuss the language that I think is the best for new developers. So language that I would suggest is actually TypeScript. TypeScript is a programming language developed and maintained by Microsoft. It is a strict syntactical superset of JavaScript. That means that it's based on JavaScript, and it adds optional static typing to the language. It is designed for the development of large applications and transpiles to JavaScript. Simplicity. It is as simple as JavaScript. As a matter of fact, if you know JS, it would take you a day or two to get pretty familiar with TypeScript. Most used for. It can be used everywhere where JavaScript is used. For example, currently I use it to build web applications in my current job at JP Morgan. How is it useful for beginners? It has the same benefit as JavaScript with huge community and it's easy to learn. However, just because it has static typing, it will teach you how to write a cleaner code with fewer bugs and inconsistencies. Every JavaScript library I have recently used already migrated from JavaScript to TypeScript. I believe that TypeScript will be the default language of the web, so you definitely cannot go wrong by choosing it. Here's the Hello World code snippet for TypeScript. Well, here you go. This is my recommendation. But before you go, if you are interested, I created a simple test exclusively for my email list subscribers where you can answer some questions, and based on your answers, the test will suggest the perfect starting language for you. So if you're interested, here's the QR code to get there. I will also include the link in the description. Hope this video was helpful for you, and again, it doesn't matter what language you are starting with, you just need to stick to it and don't quit. Please consider subscribing to my channel if you enjoyed. Good luck with your studies and bye.